idea of a test bed in the university context is doing a research project that has a practical application on campus. I'm working to look at MIT as a system and map all of our material consumption. I'm providing information to MIT by studying MIT. One of the aspects of my research is doing waste audits, taking a bunch of waste that's been freshly generated and sorting it by material type and weighing each of those categories.
From where I sit, the sustainability vector has a positive direction, and we have lots of opportunities to influence that vector and put it in, have magnitude and impact. We have the opportunity to invent the way we not only build the buildings, but also our open space. We are also, with the power plant and our distribution systems, rethinking how we provide energy. And with the analytics in place, there's a lot of room for analysis, critique, and learning.
This whole idea of campus as a testbed is very, very exciting. The cogen plant is right outside my window. I can see all the water just getting wasted of the cooling towers. It'll be the first power plants in the world to use this really amazing technology and have an impact on the water footprint of the campus. The campus itself becoming a testbed helps the entrepreneurship spirit of the campus by providing these pilots and de-risking the technology, and it helps us really reach our sustainability goals.
What we saw was a call for action from President Reif back in October 2015 that really kicked this off and accelerated these testbed environments.
MIT's climate action plan creates 8 new low-carbon energy centers within the MIT Energy Initiative. Each one of those centers is focused on a different low-carbon technology area: energy storage, advanced solar, advanced nuclear, nuclear fusion. It calls for a new environment and sustainability minor, the first time ever that MIT will be offering a comprehensive sustainability minor, a 32% reduction in campus emissions by 2030, at least. I mean, we see that as a floor. We hope to do much better than that.
Our goal with Sandbox really is to help students in every way possible connect to the right ecosystem that can help them accelerate their ideas. And we have about 30 projects that can fit into sustainability.
We're doing some incredible work on low carbon technology here, and it will be indispensable to solving the climate problem, but I'd say it's necessary and not sufficient. This is a problem that's going to require all of us contributing to it. So, you know, that means social change, behavioral change, but really getting everybody involved in being part of the solution to the problem.